I'm going to begin today with a confession. I started looking at super cheap ways to recycle 3D printed waste about 6 months ago. I ran into some issues and I abandoned that video until I could solve some of those problems. One of the things I found when melting down scrap was getting it down to a small and consistent size that can be recycled easily. And you can of course get machines to do it, but even the cheap ones aren't in the range that most hobbyists want to spend. I can tell you cutting it up manually just ain't it, but I recently came across this model on printables that I think is going to be relatively cheap and somewhat easy. But how well does it work? For printing, I chose to go for some extra strength and print it in ABS. I don't have a heated enclosure, so it meant I had to be careful with some of the corners lifting where they were far from the bed heater in the middle. And to be sure, I added some big mouse ears on a couple of parts that were close to the edge of the bed where it's not as hot. Some of these parts are a long print and I did get a little layer separation in a couple of areas. So, quick tip! These are pretty minor, but I figure this is probably going to get bashed around a bit. So to make sure it doesn't get worse, I used a soldering iron and I just run it across the separation to fuse those together. I also ran all along the inside edge where it's not visible to help fuse those layers together a bit better as well. The main body got some serious layer separation and after checking, it looks like the filament has absorbed too much water. You can see by the foamy mess on the left compared to the new roll on the right. So a quick reprint of the body with some new filament and it was all fine. There's also some parts we need to get on top of that aren't printed. So this router bit, which is going to do the cutting, I got for $12 off Amazon in a 2-pack with extra bearings and screws, link in the description. Also, the model calls for a small metal ruler to protect the printed plastic inside from wearing out against the cutting. I couldn't get one of those quickly, so you can see here I cut a can. And I guess we'll see how that goes. If you do the same, of course, those edges are going to be sharp. I also used some heat insert threads, which I already had, but you can pick these up really cheap. These were M3 6mm threads. And again, link in the description to the kit that I use. So I started putting in the threaded inserts. They can really only go into the main body side and get screwed in from the top and the bottom. If you haven't used threaded inserts before, they really do give a level of professionalism to your print. So if you're new, I'd suggest get a kit of a whole bunch of different sizes and give them a go. So however I say aluminium, I'll get comments to say I'm wrong, so I'll try and annoy everyone. The aluminium strip goes in next, or the metal ruler if you have it. I put that aluminium so that it pokes out and tried to bend it over just a tiny bit where it pokes out the other side so it holds in. Now the idea is that metal comes very close to the router bit, but not touching. And on the outside, there's some holes that you can screw a little bolt into if you have the really rigid metal ruler inserted to push as close as you can to the router if you need to. I'm not going to with the aluminium because it's already slightly bending out and I'm getting less confident that this bit's going to work. I slotted in the router bit. For me, it was a really nice tight fit. If you have issues with the fit, I'd suggest a tolerance test print and see if you need to adjust your XY compensation in Prusa slicer or Orca slicer, or I think it's slicing tolerance in Cura. Then screw the three main parts together and looks like we've got a shredder. I used a small clean bottle for the catchment and I feel like we might build up a bit of static here, so I guess we'll see. So the first test was a little daunting, mainly because I knew the kind of pressure this would be under and I wasn't sure if it would explode in my face. The clamping foot as part of the main body is a great feature, so I clamped that down with, surprise, surprise, a clamp. I fed in a small amount of scrap, attached an old cordless drill and it shredded pretty quickly too. It was a little chunky, but compared to the manual cutting I was doing for my other video, I can see this is a game changer that's going to let that project continue now. great part of this model also is nothing's escaping, and I can just take the bottle off, put another one on, and really easily, if I need to, refeed that first shred through to go through smaller. I did end up having a problem with the aluminum shield that I made, and clearly it wasn't strong enough to hold up against the pressure of the parts getting shredded up against it. I took an expansion card blank off an old PC that I had, and I cut it down a tiny bit outside once I got some sparks going, and it slid in really well. So if you're doing this as cheap as possible, that might be an option for you too. While that metal part was now strong enough, I managed to blow out the back of the main body, probably by overloading the amount of scrap I was feeding in at once, to be honest. But also, that body probably wasn't printed in the right orientation, so I tried the original that I had some of the layer separation going on with. I made sure to get those bolts and the metal shield, I want to call it, as close as possible to the router bit, and that really ensures that those chunks don't get caught as far down and put too much pressure on that metal and do exactly what I just did and blow it out. After I got all that sorted, it went really well. The manual mess I cut by hand here probably took about 45 to 50 minutes, and I got this much. In 10 minutes, I managed to get this much out of the shredder. Now, definitely worked better on particular types of scrap. Supports like this and scrap that is kind of a little bit chunky worked best, I think, because it was able to hit the router bit straight on and not get caught up jamming down the side. Actual filament was a little hit and miss until I got that metal shield tuned as close as I could. Before that, it sometimes had enough space to just get pushed through without getting cut up. And really flat pieces that were maybe only one or two layers didn't cut up very well at all. I managed to get through sometimes, or sometimes what would happen, which was even worse, is that it would get clogged up in the bottom part. And it meant more scrap couldn't actually feed through until I got that out. So can I recommend it? 100%. I think there might be a couple of tweaks to make it perfect. So watch out for remixes on printables from me if no one else does it first. I've got a lot of scrap to go through, so watch out for upcoming videos on what I do to recycle this scrap now on a real budget, and maybe use it in ways you might not have thought of. Let everyone know in the comments ways you found to recycle scraps. After printing this model, that step in my recycling scrap project is one step easier. So hopefully everyone found this useful. We'll see you next time.